And people of God, and just begin to worship. I feel Jesus. Glory to God. Just begin to worship. Worship Him. Worship Him. Worship Him. Come on, just set the atmosphere. Break the yokes by worshiping. That is how we evoke the presence of the Lord, through worship. Come on, people of God, just begin to worship. Hallelujah. Begin to worship. Begin to worship. Thank you, great O God. We bless your holy name as you are logging on and sharing. Glory to God. Just begin to worship. Let your comments be worship. Begin to worship. Begin to worship. Before we complain about anything, before we ask God for anything, before we petition the throne of grace for anything, we set our hearts and our minds. We are intentional in our worship, and we begin to worship our King. We lift up His holy name. We magnify the great name of our Jesus. We magnify His holy name, for His name is holy. His name is righteous. Ekaraboshaya. He is holy. He is righteous. We praise Him in the name of Jesus. In spite of it all, through it all, no matter what it looks like, no matter what we feel, no matter what we experience, we lift up our hands and we glorify Him. We lift up our hands and we give Him worship. As you are commenting, hallelujah, come in worshiping Him. I feel a shift. I feel a release in the name of Jesus. I feel a release in the name of Jesus. There will be nothing hindering us from this move of God. There will be nothing hindering us from what the Lord is about to do. There will be nothing hindering us from His power. There will be nothing hindering us from seeking His face, from seeking His presence, from tapping into His glory. We give you glory, O God. We magnify you, Father. We glorify you, God. You are worthy. Through it all, you are worthy. Counter to counter, you are worthy. From coast to coast, you are worthy. You are worthy, God. We praise you, God, for we know that every good and perfect thing comes from you. We glorify you, God, for we know, God, that if it had not been for you, we would not be here. And we glorify your name. We magnify your name. We bless your holy name. There's none other like you. There's nobody like you. There's nothing. Nothing about, oh God, nothing can compare to you. Nothing can supersede you. Nothing can outdo you. We praise you, God, from the mountain high. We thank you, God, through the valley low. We magnify and we bless your holy name. We praise you for healing. We thank you for healing. We thank you for saving us. Is there anybody right now who's grateful that God saved you? Are you thankful that He saved you? Are you thankful that He healed you? Are you thankful that He delivered you? Are you? Can we bless Him? Hallelujah. Can we bless Him, God? Can we bless Him? Can we bless Him? Elaboshaya, because He brought us out. Can you praise Him because He brought us through? Can you praise Him because He made a way? He is a way maker. He is a way maker. That is His nature. That is His characteristic. Hashaya, that is His characteristics. That is His makeup. That is who He is. He is a way maker. He is a promise keeper. There is no shadow of turning within Him. He changes not. Hallelujah. We praise you, God, for you keep every promise. You manifest your word. You manifest your word. We can count on you, God. We can lean on you, God. We can depend on you, Father. We can, oh God, we can count on you, God, for you are forever faithful. You are forever, God, yes, God. You are forever a keeper. You kept us, God, and you kept us in perfect peace. We praise you now, God, for you kept us in perfect peace. We give you glory. We give you praise. You kept us in perfect peace. You made a way, Father. You made a way when it was no way. You made a way in the midst of destruction. You made a way in the midst of calamity. You made a way in the midst of pain. You made a way in the midst of trials. You made a way, God, when we couldn't see a way. You made a way, God, because that is who you are. That is who you are. That is who you are. You healed our bodies. You delivered our minds. You brought us through, God. You brought us out, God, for that is who you are. Yes, Father, you kept us, for that is who you are. You alleviated stress, for that is who you are. You carried the load, for that is who you are. You brought us through, for that is who you are. You, oh God, you blessed us, God. You kept us, Father, for that is who you are, God. And we glorify your name, and we magnify your name. We praise you, oh God, because you elevated us. God, you brought us through, Father. Oh God, when the obstacles were against us, God, we praise you, God, because there is no obstacle that's too hard for you. We bless your holy name, Father, that when the odds were stacked against us, it was not too hard for you. We praise you, God, in the name of Jesus, that we still trust in you. We still believe in you. We still know that you can do it. Even if you choose not to do it at this time, you are still yet able. And we glorify you, God, for you are an able God. You can do anything but fail. And we give you glory, Father, and we magnify your name. We bless you, God, and we give you a new yes. We give you a new yes, God. We say yes to you, Father. We say yes to your will. We say yes to your way. We say yes in our homes. We say yes in our heart. We say yes, oh God. We say yes to your word. We say yes to your move. We say yes to your vision. We give you a new yes, God. We give you a recommitted yes. We give you a dedicated yes. We give you our whole heart. For God, you are worthy, God. God, you are worthy, God. You are worthy of our whole praise. You are worthy of our whole heart. We give you glory, oh God. God, you deserve this new yes. We tell you yes, Father. We give you a new yes on today. Yesterday's yes will not do it. Yesterday's yes is not sufficient. Yesterday's yes will not make it. But God, on today, Father, we give you a new yes, God. For God, you loaded us, oh God, every single day with daily benefits, for you are our daily bread. And God, since you are our daily bread, we give you a new yes every day. We tell you yes even when we don't feel like it. We tell you yes even if we can't see it. We tell you yes even if we don't know it. We tell you yes even if we're in a dark place. We tell you yes even with pain in our body. We tell you yes as we're going through the obstacles. For God, when we go through with you, we already got the victory, and we give you glory, Father. We thank you, oh God. Come on, Zion, open up your mouth and praise him for the victory. Your yes, yes, God. Your victory is connected to your yes. Your deliverance is connected to your yes. The way being made is connected to your yes. Yes, God, how the Lord is going to shift it is connected into your yes. Lord, we don't tell you no. We don't tell you no, God. But God, we give you a renewed yes. We give you a today's yes. We give you a right now, yes. We praise you, God. For God, we're walking in victory because we told you yes, God. We're walking in the overflow because we told you yes, God. We're walking in a new strength because we told you yes, God. We're walking in new victory because we gave you a yes, God. God, we give you a new yes. We give you a brand new yes. We will not bow down. We will not compromise. We will not sugarcoat the gospel. But God, we give you a new yes. We are not ashamed, Father, to proclaim your name. We are not ashamed, oh God, to call on your name. Because God, there's healing in your name. There's deliverance in your name, Jesus. Yokes are destroyed in your name, Jesus. We praise you now, Lord, for we know to drop the right name. We don't drop our name. We don't drop man's name. But Holy Ghost of God, we drop the name of Jesus. For God, at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess. God, we say the name of Jesus on the mountaintops and in the valley low. We call on the name of Jesus everywhere we go, Father. For God, we are not ashamed. We are not ashamed, yes, God, that we're covered in the blood. We are not ashamed that we're blood covered. We are not ashamed that we're walking in your glory. We are not ashamed that we walk in your name. We are not ashamed that we come in the book of the volume that is written of you. We are not ashamed, oh God. We are not ashamed, oh God. Let them say what they want to say about us. Let them call us Jesus freaks. Let them call us holy rollers. But God, we are not ashamed to call on your name. For God, we know that at the name of Jesus, demons tremble. At the name of Jesus, yokes are destroyed. At the name of Jesus, burdens are lifted. At the name of Jesus, death got to back up. At the name of Jesus, yes, God, sickness got to beg up at the name of Jesus. The cancer has to dissolve at the name of Jesus. The enemy got to flee at the name of Jesus. The accusers must put down their rocks at the name of Jesus. Wars are destroyed. Wars are ended at the name of Jesus. God, your people are walking in victory, and we give you glory, God. For God, we're walking in the victory of Jesus. We praise you now, God. We glorify you now, God. For God, we know that our weapons of this warfare are not carnal, but God, they're mighty in God for the pulling down of strongholds. And in the name of Jesus, every stronghold that's attacking the people of God today, we pull down that stronghold of debt, that stronghold of inferiority, that stronghold of depression, strongholds on the mind, strongholds on the will, strongholds on the body, strongholds on the spirit, strongholds on the vision. We pull it down now in the name of Jesus. We praise your holy name that the stronghold is destroyed. The stronghold is broken. Strong man, loose your grip. Strong man, loose your hold. In the name of Jesus. Yeah, God, you will not die. We speak to the depression. We speak to the low self-esteem. We speak to the heaviness of the mind. And we call your mind back to the mind of Christ. For the Bible says, let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus. We praise you now, God, that you are regulating minds on today. We give you glory, God, that the people of God will not suffer. They won't suffer with dementia. They won't suffer with Alzheimer's. God, right now, Holy Ghost, touch the mind of the older generation. Touch the mind of the seasoned saints. In the name of Jesus, we praise you that the doctor says it will not happen. But God, you can touch the mind. Touch it right now, Father. We speak to the seizures. We speak to the electrical impulses. We speak to the stroke in the brain. In the name of Jesus, we destroy every blood vessel that's trying to constrict in the mind and the brain. In the name of Jesus, high blood pressure, hypertension right now, we speak to it. We command it to release. We command it to be broken. We command you to be healed. In the name of Jesus, Holy Ghost of God, we speak to the yes, God. We speak to heart disease, CHF, COPD, emphysema. Yes, God, we speak to it right now. And we don't ask, but we command in the name of Jesus that it loose your grip and loose your hold. We didn't come to beg no infirmity to be released off of your body. But God, in the name of Jesus, you said in your word that if there be any sick among you, to call for the elders of the church. Yes, God, pray in the prayer of faith. Yeah, God, we lay hands. We touch and agree in the name of Jesus that every diagnosis that's attacking your blood, that's attacking your breathing, is destroyed right now in the name of Jesus. You will not need the oxygen. You will not need the COPD machine. You will not need the sleep apnea machine. We command right now every tormenting spirit that's attacking you in your sleep to be destroyed right now in the name of Jesus. We command right now every spirit that's trying to take away your breath while you are asleep, we command it to be destroyed right now. Every generational sickness, every inherited sickness, every bloodline sickness that's attacking the bodies and attacking you while you're asleep, the spirit of the Lord is, God, is against it right now. In the name of Jesus, we speak right now. In the name of Jesus, to every demon, every succubus demon, every incubus demon that's trying to attack the people of God in their sleep, we destroy it right now. We plead the blood of Jesus, the blood over your bedroom, the blood over your mind, the blood over your spirit, the blood over your heart. In the name of Jesus, while you are sleeping, every demonic attack will be destroyed right now. We fold, yes, God. We uncover and we dismantle every demonic spirit that's attacking your mind in the name of Jesus. We destroy, yes, God, in the name of Jesus, the spirit of Leviathan. We come against the python spirit that's trying to suffer suffocate you. Every suffocating sister, every suffocating brother that's under the sound of my voice. Yeah, God, be ye set free in the name of Jesus. Your dreams will not suffocate. Your vision will not suffocate. You will not give up in well-doing, for you shall reap. If you faint not, we cut off the head of the snake. We cut off the tail of the snake. We dismantle right now every venomous spirit that's attacking your spirit, that's attacking your breath. In the name of Jesus, we come against every spirit, every wind-taking spirit that's trying to take your breath away. We destroy it right now in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost of God, come in and touch. Sweep through this place, God, like a rushing mighty wind, where the winds of confusion are trying to come against your people. In the name of Jesus, Holy Ghost of God, sweep through right now. Send a fresh wind. Send a refreshing wind. Send a refreshing wind over these your people. In the name of Jesus, send a refreshing wind. The enemy think he won, but God, there's a refreshing wind that's flowing on your people. It's flowing on today. And these winds are not empty. These winds are not in vain. But God, we praise you that the winds of favor, the winds of increase, the winds of miracles, the winds of revival are flowing fresh on these your people. God, move through. God, blow through. Come in like a tsunami. Come in like a tornado. Come in like a hurricane. Let the hurricane winds of favor flow down on these your people. Let the winds of increase blow on, yes, God. Let it blow on your finances in the name of Jesus. Because I hear God saying, you too anointed, you're too favored to be going through what you're going through. You're too favored to be about to lose your mind. You're too favored to walk in defeat. You're too favored to walk in a down place. You're too favored to walk in a broke place. You're too favored by God. The hand of God covers you. The hand of God is on you. You will not be defeated. You will not be, yes, God, broken. You will not be overtaken. But in the name of Jesus, you're getting ready to raise up. You're about to raise up. You're about to come forward like a great army. In the name of Jesus, according to Ezekiel, the 37th chapter, and God told Ezekiel, he said, yes, God, son of man, can these dry bones live? I need to ask somebody a question. Yes, God, it looked like you were dry. You were in a dry place. You were in a desert place. You were in a place of no growth. You were in a place of no advancement. You were in a place of no progression. You were in a place where you felt like you could not go higher. You felt like you could not grow. You felt like you could not move. You said, God, is hard. It's hard to be faithful when I'm in a dry place. It's hard to keep moving when I'm in a dry place. It's hard to grow when I'm in a dry place. It's hard to move when I'm in a dry place. But God asked Ezekiel, can these dry bones live? They had been dead for years and years. They were so dead. They had been dead for so long that there was no skin on the body. There was no muscle on the body. There was nothing on the bones. It was nothing but bones. And I need to prophesy to somebody right now what it looks like. You at the end of the rope. You're, hey, Lord, you're holding on by bones. You're just in a bony place. You're in a dry place. But God asked Ezekiel, he said, can these dry bones live? Can the thing that looks like it's been dead for a long time, can it live? Can the very thing that people buried, can it live? Can the very thing that had no movement, can it live? Can the very thing that had no strength, can it live? It had no muscles. It had no tendons. It had no wind. It had no muscles.
movement. It had no strength. But God asked them a question. Can it live? And I need to ask somebody who's praying right now. God is asking you. I know what you look like. I know what it looks like. I know how it feels like you're going through right now. But baby, you are getting ready. You're getting ready to live. And God told Ezekiel, prophesy to the bones. Everybody right now who's praying with us, prophesy to your bones. Prophesy to that dry place. Prophesy, yes, God. Prophesy to that empty place. Prophesy to that place where it looks like there's no growth. Prophesy where it looks like there's no progress. Prophesy where it looks like it cannot move. Prophesy because your promise obeys your voice, not the voice of the enemy, not the voice of the haters, but your prophecy is waiting for you to prophesy. Your Yedahashiah, your prophecy is waiting on you to prophesy. Prophesy to your finances. Prophesy to your family. Prophesy over your children. Prophesy over your ministry. Prophesy over your career. Prophesy over your vision. Prophesy over your mandate. Prophesy. Open up your mouth and speak right now that they shall live. Yeah, God. But God said not only just yeah, God. Yeah, God. Living ain't enough. Getting up ain't enough. Yes, God. That ain't enough in God because they had been dead for so long. That ain't enough in God. He said prophesy. Yeah, God. He told them in Ezekiel, the 37th chapter. Oh, Lord. He said again, prophesy to the bones and tell them bones. Hear the word of the Lord. That's Ezekiel 37 and 4. He said, hear the word of the Lord. Then the Lord said unto these bones, I will cause breath to enter into you and you shall live. Can I prophesy that God is about to breathe in your situation? Can I prophesy right now? I need to let somebody know that God is about to breathe. Yeah, God, in your situation, he's about to give you mouth-to-mouth resuscitation. He's about to give you CPR. He's about to resurrect. He's about to breathe in your place that was dry. He's about to breathe in the place with no growth. He's about to breathe. God, breathe on me. Open up your mouth and declare right now, God, breathe on me. Breathe on my ministry. Breathe on my mind. Breathe on my heart. Breathe on my finances. Breathe on my career. Breathe on my business. Everything connected to me, God, breathe on it. Send the fresh wind. Send the Holy Ghost power. Breathe on me. Send your pneuma. Breathe on it, God. Yeah, God. And so the Bible says that thus saith the Lord in Ezekiel 37 and 5. Hallelujah. He said that the Lord will call these bones. He said, behold, I will cause breath to enter into you and you shall live. But that ain't it. He says, and I will lay sinews, that's muscles and tendons, come on somebody, upon you. And I will bring up the flesh upon you. I will cover you. Y'all don't want to have no church. So not only are you going to have breath, not only are you going to live, but God says, I'm going to give you sinews. I'm going to give you muscles and tendons. I'm going to give you back your strength. Lord, help me in here today. I'm going to give you back your strength. Somebody felt empty, but there's a newfound strength that's getting ready to come your way. Somebody was depleted, but there's a newfound strength that's getting ready to come your way. Somebody felt like, I can't go any further. I've been carrying this burden for too long. My strength has been taken away from me, but I need to let somebody know that God says, your strength is coming back. Glory be to God. And then the Bible says, I will cover you with skin. Lord, help me in here today. Not only are you going to get your breath back, not only are you going to get your strength back, but God said, I'm going to cover you because what you went through before, I got you covered. Even if you go through it again, it won't have the same effect on you because I got you covered. Lord, help me in here today. He's got you covered. You are not by yourself. You are not going through by yourself. You are not out there by yourself. You are not in in the wind by yourself. You are not in the fight by yourself, because God says, I got you covered. Greater is he, I feel God, that is within you than he that is in the world. Can I let somebody know that your Bible says no weapon formed against you will be able to prosper. He has you covered. He's got you protected. Yes, God, and I will cover you with skin. I will put breath in you, and you shall live and know that I am the Lord thy God. Ezekiel 37:7 says that Ezekiel said, so I prophesied. I prophesied as I was commanded. I spoke it like he told me to speak it. I said it the way he said, say it. I did it the way he said, do it. I couldn't do it my way, but I prophesied how God told me to prophesy. He, oh my God, I prophesied. I spoke it exactly how God told me to speak it. I didn't speak it in my own voice. I didn't speak it the way I wanted to speak it, but I prophesied as I was commanded. Somebody said, I'm not a prophet. I can't prophesy. Lord, have mercy. Help me in here today. Oh God, but you better open up your mouth and you better speak what God says about you. You better speak what he spoke about you. And the Bible says that after Ezekiel, he prophesied as he was commanded. Help me in here today. Then there was a noise. Then there was a noise. Lord, you're getting ready to hear something. Woman of God, you're getting ready to hear something. Man of God, you're getting ready to hear something. Something is getting ready to happen. Something is getting ready to happen. You may hear it before you see it. You may hear it before you see it. Because the Bible says faith cometh by hearing, and hearing the word of God. You may hear it before you see it. The Bible says there was a noise. Something began to happen. There was a noise. Can anybody in here hear what I hear? Can you hear what I hear? Can you hear what I hear? I hear God doing something. I hear God bringing something together. I hear God, yes, God, assembling some things together. Can you hear what I hear? You may not be able to see it, but can you hear what I hear? I hear a shaking. I hear a rumbling. I hear God is about to do something on your behalf. I hear something that's coming closer to you. I hear a sound in the atmosphere. I hear a train coming through. The Holy Ghost is about to come through like a locomotive. The Holy Ghost is about to come through on your behalf. Can you hear what I hear? Can you hear? Oh, I'm about to run up out of here. Can you hear what I hear? And so the Bible says there was a noise. After the noise, there was a shaking. Can I let somebody know? I don't know who I'm talking to, but the Bible says there was a noise, and then there was a shaking. Can you, oh Lord, God is about to shake some things up on your behalf. God is about to stir some things up on your behalf. God is about to shake up some things on your behalf. God is about to shake up. There's about to be a shaking. There's about to be a trembling. There's about to be a shaking. When things begin to shake, Lord have mercy. That means that everything in the container is about to come together. When you shake up a bottle, that means that everything inside the bottle is about to come together. When you shake up, yes, God. When you shake up, yeah, God. When you shake up something that has ingredients in it. When you shake it up, as long as it's standing still, everything is floating down. But when you begin to shake it up, the things begin to come together. Yeah, God, there's a noise and there's a shaking. God is bringing together. He's shaking together. He's bringing it together. He's bringing the pieces together. He's shaking you up and he's bringing you together. He's shaking up your ministry and he's bringing it together. He's shaking up your family. He's bringing them together. He's shaking up, oh God, he's shaking up your career. He's bringing it together. The Bible says that there was a shaking and the bones came together, bone to bone, bone to his bone. And then the Bible says Ezekiel 37 and 8. And I beheld that, Lord, that the sinews and the flesh came up on them and the skin covered up on them, but there was no breath in them. And then the Bible says that God says, prophesy, that God told Ezekiel in Ezekiel 37 and 9, prophesy to the wind. Y'all don't want to have no church up in here. What are you waiting on? Who do you want, God? You waiting on a prophet to prophesy over you? My God in heaven, the Bible says that God told Ezekiel, prophesy to the wind. If I don't ever prophesy to you, if the preacher don't ever prophesy to you, if the evangelist don't ever prophesy to you, open up your mouth and prophesy over yourself. Prophesy to the wind. Prophesy to the waves. Prophesy to that enemy. Prophesy to that sickness. Lord, I feel God up in here. Prophesy to your finances. Prophesy to your bank account. Prophesy over your home. Prophesy over your children. Prophesy, Edible Shire. Prophesy over your possessions. Prophesy over your life. Prophesy over your street, over your future. He said, prophesy unto the wind and tell the wind, say, son of man. He said, say to the wind, thus says the Lord of God, come forth from the four winds, breathe and breathe upon these that are slain, that they may heal, that they may live. And Ezekiel said, I did exactly what he told me to do. I prophesied as he commanded me, and breath came in them, and they lived, and they stood up, a great and exceeding army. Y'all don't know when to shout. The very things that was dry, the very things, hallelujah, that they had no growth, the very thing that had been buried, the very thing that was dry, the very thing that was some bones. Oh my God, after God, hey God, told Ezekiel to prophesy to it, the bones became an army. Lord, and can somebody understand? I need to let about 12, yes God, about 200 prayer warriors who are praying on Periscope, and about 1,000 people who are praying on Facebook Live. I need to let somebody know, and to everybody on the prayer line, that God is about to take your bones and make them into an army. He's about to take the very thing that was empty and turn it into an army. He's about to take the very thing, yes God, that was buried and turn it into an army. Lord, help me in here today. It looked like it was buried, but God said it was never buried. Oh my God, you remember Jairus' daughter, yes God, in the Gospels, Jairus' daughter, they told you, he went to Jesus, he said, come lay your hands on my little girl so that she may live. But Jesus was held up by the woman with the issue of blood. Lord have mercy. And it looked like he was late getting to Jairus' house. The folk that was at the house came to Jairus and told him, don't trouble the teacher any longer because your daughter is dead. Jesus, when he showed up, he put everybody out. Everybody that was wailing. He said, why y'all doing all this crying? Why y'all making all this commotion? The damsel is not dead, but she is asleep. Baby, you were never dead, but you were asleep. Your vision was never dead, but it was asleep. Your ministry was never dead, but it was asleep. Your marriage was never dead, but God said it was asleep. Oh my God, the people started laughing. The people started joking. The people started saying, yeah, I know he's crazy now, but Jesus put them all out. He only took the ones that had faith. He only took the ones, my God, who could see what he saw, who could hear what he heard. He only took them and the girl's parents, and he went in the room. Lord, have mercy. Can I prophesy to somebody right here that Jesus is coming in the room? Oh, God, help me in here today. Jesus is coming in the room. You thought you were by yourself, but he's coming in the room. You thought it was over for you, but he's coming in the room. You thought it was the end, but he's coming in the room. They said you were dead. They said it wouldn't happen, but Jesus said, I'm coming in the room. And no, it looked like I had forgotten about it, but I'm coming in the room, because God said, if I told you that I'm going to come see about you, oh my God, even if it dies, it can't stay dead. He said, if I told you that I'm going to heal your body, even if you get worse, you won't die. He said, if I told you that I'm going to bring your child out, even if they get worse, the enemy won't have the last stand, because God is getting ready. ready to come in the room. Lord, have mercy. He said the girl was never dead, but she was asleep. And watch what he did. He grabbed her by the hand. Help me in her, Holy Ghost. He took her by the hand. Oh, God. He took her by the hand. And he commanded the girl, Talitha Kuma, which is translated, little girl, I say to you, arise. Somebody in here this morning, you're getting ready to arise. You're getting ready to walk out. You're getting ready to get up. You're getting ready to get up. You're getting ready to stand up. You're getting ready to get up. He said, little girl, arise. It's time for you to get up. Oh my God, I wish I had somebody in here that would stand up. Get up off depression. Stand up. I know you're tired, but he said, little girl, arise. I know you're wounded, but he said, little girl, arise. I know you got pain in your body, but you better get up with your pain-ridden self. I know you're going through the fight of your life, but God says, it's time for you to get up. It's time for you to get up. It's time for you to get up. Oh my God, I can't hear nobody. It's time for you to get up. Get up from where you are. Get up off that bed. Stop feeling sorry for yourself. Watch this, y'all. When she got up, Lord have mercy. Lord, good God Almighty, he told her to arise. What that means is to stand on your own two feet. What that means is to get up and stand up on your own. You may have had help before, but this time you're getting ready to get up and you're going to stand up on your own. You're going to stand up on your own two feet. You won't need a co-signer. Y'all don't know when to shout. You won't need somebody to validate for you. Y'all don't know when to give him glory. You won't need, come on somebody, you won't need somebody to give you a down payment, because you're getting ready to stand up on your own two feet. You're getting ready to get up on your own two feet. I wish, oh God, somebody shout arise. I'm getting up. I got to get up. Somebody type right now, come in the comment section, get up. Yes, God. Somebody type your name. He said, little girl, arise. Type your name right now. Terry, arise. Arlene, arise. Shannon, arise. Yes, God. Jacob, arise. Yes, God. Stephen, arise. Come on here, somebody. Valerie, arise. Tamika, arise. Melody, arise. Philippia, arise. Belinda, arise. I can hear somebody. Open up your mouth. I need every prayer warrior to put your name in it. Yes, God. Put you in the scripture. Put your name in the scripture. LaTrice, arise. Stephanie, arise. To wonder, arise. Oh my God, whatever your business is, yes God, your business shall arise in the name of Jesus. Put it right now. Speak over it. Prophesy to it. Prophesy over your church. Christy, arise. Temple, arise. Serena, arise. Tamika, arise. Lakeisha, arise. Sean, arise. Come on somebody, open up your mouth. Xavier, arise. Y'all don't want to have no church. Tina, arise. Mama Lisa, arise. Robert, arise. You're getting ready to get up, Robert. You've been down for too long, but you're getting ready to get up. But when you get up this time, Robert, you're not getting up as Robert that went down, but you're getting up a warrior. You're getting up a fighter. You're coming up with power. Selena, arise. Open up your mouth. Arise. Get up and walk. Get up and take your place. Get up and go forward. Come on here, somebody. Get up and go forward. Get up and go forward. Get up and arise. Get up and arise. Get up and arise. Get up and arise. Come on, Zion. Yeah, God. Rona, arise. In the name of Jesus. Child on a mission, arise. Open up your mouth and give God a shout. Arise, arise, arise. Y'all, I got to go. I got to catch a flight. I got to go. The Wilson family, arise. The Wilson family, arise. Here it is. Here it is. Here it is. Quentin, arise. Frederick, arise. Gavin, arise. Lord, help me in here. Empower Outreach Ministry, arise. I got to go. I got to go. Here it is, y'all. Here it is. Here it is. Here it is. I told you, arise, right? Arise, arise, arise. Lord, have mercy. The Bible says, I got to read this. I got to read this. It's one of my favorite scriptures. I got to read it. Kenneth Arise. I got to read it. 1 Peter 5 and 10. Oh, God, help me in here. I'm about to run up out of here. Stedman Arise. I'm about to run up out of here. Lord, help me in here, Holy Ghost. I'm about to run up out of here because I see some people that used to be bones, but you're getting up now. I see some folk that was once buried, but you're getting up now. I see some people of God that who were once buried, but you are getting up now. You are arising now. I can't stay buried. Oh, my God, help me in here today. I cannot stay buried. I cannot stay buried. I cannot stay buried. Because when you bury me, baby, guess what's on the inside of me? There's a word on the inside of me. And my word is my seed. So even when it looks like I'm buried, baby, that seed is about to come up. That word is about to spring forth. Brandon, arise. That word is about to spring forth. I cannot stay buried. I cannot stay down. I cannot stay on my back. I cannot stay defeated. Oh, help me in here today. I cannot stay defeated. You cannot stay depleted. You cannot stay empty. You cannot stay on the back. You cannot stay on the backside. You cannot stay broken. You cannot stay sick. You cannot stay. Oh, God, I thank you, God. Somebody with stomach issues. Yes, God, gastrointestinal issues. Holy Ghost of God, you've been having ulcers, colon issues. Glory be to God. God says he's healing your body in the name of Jesus. You will not stay down, but you are about to arise. You will not stay broken, but you are about to arise. Lupus has to go. Lupus cannot stay in your body, but it's about to arise in the name of Jesus. When you go back to your gastro doctor, when you go back to your cardiologist, when you go back to your nephrologist, when you go back to your neurologist, when you go back to the specialist, yes, God, in the name of Jesus, what they saw will not be there anymore. What was once there will not be there anymore. Thyroid issues in all my shire are being depleted and defeated right now in the name of Jesus. God has given you back your strength. God is healing your body, for he is Jehovah Jireh. He is Jehovah Rapha. He was wounded for your transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of his peace is upon his shoulders, and by his stripes we are healed in the name of Jesus. Tell that infirmity, you may as well take that back. You may as well go on somewhere, because my body is healed in the name of Jesus. It will not stay in me. I will not stay broken. It will not stay what it is. It will not remain what it is. It will not remain how it is in the name of Jesus, because you're about to arise. Holy Ghost of God, everybody on the line that's going through financial issues, hallelujah, going through a financial strain, hallelujah, going through a drought, going through a famine, you had to make some cutbacks, you had to make some adjustments, you may have lost some things, you may have lost some resources, but God said, I got a word for you. That word is found in 1 Peter 5 and 10, Holy Ghost of God, from the Message version of the Bible, where the Bible says, the suffering will not last forever. Y'all don't know when to shout. The suffering will not last forever. That financial suffering, yeah, God, that fiscal suffering, your business suffering, your career suffering, oh, help me in here, Holy Ghost, your house suffering, the suffering will not last forever. Lord, help me in here today. It will not last forever. You know what's gonna last forever. Lord, have mercy. The word of God is the only thing that'll last forever. Help me in here, Holy Ghost, because your suffering has an expiration date. Your suffering has a time limit. Your pain that you've been in, it has a time limit. But God said the suffering won't last forever. He said it won't be long before this generous God, who has great plans for us in Christ, eternal and glorious plans they are, that he will put you back together and on your feet for good. He's about to put you back together. He's about to put you back together. I know you were broken, but you're getting ready to come back together. Yeah, God, help me, Father. I know you were broken, but you're coming back together. I know you were wounded, but you're coming back together. I know you were, yes, God, I know it felt like you were separated. You are being pulled apart. Is there anybody today who's been feeling like I'm being pulled apart? I'm being pulled in every direction. I'm being pulled from every place. God said, oh my God. Yeah, God. You're being pulled in this direction. You're being pulled in that direction. You're being pulled from here. You're being pulled from there. Help me in here, Holy Ghost. God is about, hallelujah. God is about to put you back together. I want to read that scripture again, but I want to read it from the Amplified Version. The Bible says, after you have suffered a little while, come on somebody, after you have suffered a while, the God of all grace, who imparts his blessing and favor, who called you to his own eternal glory in Christ, will himself complete you, confirm you, strengthen you, establish you, making you what you ought to be. The suffering will not last forever because God is getting ready to do. He's getting ready to do something on your behalf. Watch this. He's about to complete you. He's about to complete the thing that's concerning you. I don't know if you looked at your calendar lately, but we're in the seventh month. We're in the month of July. We're in the month of completion. And can I let somebody know that God said I'm about to complete that thing. Not only am I going to complete it, but God said I'm going to confirm it. Holy Ghost of God, he's going to confirm it. Lord have mercy. When something has been confirmed, that means that God said it is so. Oh Lord, help me today. When something is confirmed, that means that God says it is so. Lord, help me to God. Help me in here today. Yes, God, what is on your altar that looked like it was up in the air? God said it's completed. And it is so. Lord Jesus, what is on your altar that looked like it was not going to happen? God said the warfare is completed. And your yes, God, and your answer is it is so. Not only that, he will strengthen you and establish you. He's going to plant you. He's going to put you right on your feet. You're getting ready to stand up. In the name of Jesus, I speak to every person that's been going through a storm that the storm is over. The storm is over. The warfare is over. The heartache is over. The sickness is over. If that thing is over, that test that you've been in, God said it's over. That pain and trial that you've been in, God says it's over. That stress won't take you out. That stress won't make you lose your mind. That stress will not distress you any longer. God says it's over. He's confirming you. Hey, God, he's completing you. He's strengthening you and he's establishing you in the name of Jesus. The devil is a liar. The devil is defeated. Hell is defeated in the name of Jesus. We break off every demonic spirit that's been attacking your life. We dismantle right now. We dismantle right now. We dismantle right now that demonic attack, that demonic arsenal, that demonic launch that's been coming up against you. We cancel it and we destroy it in the name of Jesus. We speak over your children. We speak over your grandchildren. We speak over your career. We speak over your home that the blood covers in the name of Jesus. Death will not enter. Death will not have the final say. Death will not, yes, God, destroy. No premature death on your loved ones. God, yes, God, we decree and declare a long life in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, God. Strengthening your mind. Strengthening your faith in the name of Jesus. For you walk by faith and not by sight. Hallelujah, Father. In the name of Jesus, every dry thing is over in your life. Because, oh God, God is releasing rivers. God is releasing rivers right now. God is releasing. God, release the rivers. God, release the rivers. Release the rivers. Release the rivers. Release the rivers in their lives. Release the rivers in their finances. We command the rivers, multiple streams, to flow right now. Release the rivers in the name of Jesus. Release the overflow in the name of Jesus. Release it right now. Release the rivers, God. Let the rivers flow. Release the rivers, Father. Release the rivers, God, in the name of Jesus. The rivers over every drought. The rivers over every dry place. The rivers over every dark. dark place, the rivers over every desert, the rivers in the famine, the rivers right now, in the name of Jesus, release the flow, God, release the overflow. We command, we decree, we declare, in the name of Jesus, release the rivers for the suffering. The suffering is destroyed, for the rivers are flowing over. The suffering is no more, for the rivers are overflowing out of your belly, out of your belly, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water, rivers of favor, rivers of healing, rivers of overflow, rivers of his glory, rivers of his revival, rivers of fire, rivers of increase, rivers are flowing over in the name of Jesus. Not another drought. We destroy in the name of Jesus every drought, every dry place. Every dry place has been replaced with the rivers of revival, the rivers of his fire, the rivers of his glory. Overflow, overflow of power, overflow of power, overflow of your glory, overflow of your spirit in the name of Jesus. God, surround these your people with your glory, God. Surround these your people with your presence, God. Surround these your people with your fire, God. Surround these your people with the presence of the Lord, an undeniable presence. God, tabernacle our space with the rivers of glory. God, tabernacle our environment with the rivers of glory, that when we go into our jobs, the rivers of the Lord will meet us there in the name of Jesus. When we go into our place of employment, that the rivers of the Lord will meet us there in the name of Jesus. God, right now, when we go into the schools, when we go into the colleges, when we go into the road, when we go into the doctor, when we go into the courtroom, the rivers of the Lord will flow over, God, and meet us there in the name of Jesus. God, let your power, God, let your presence, let it flow, God, let it overtake us, God. The rivers of release, the rivers of release, the rivers of revival, the rivers of restoration, the rivers of Yehoshua, the rivers of redemption, in the name of Jesus. Yeah, God, let it overflow, let it flow over, let it flow over, let it flow over. God, don't stop it, God, don't block it, don't let it plug up, in the name of Jesus, until it overtakes us. Yeah, God, overtake, overtake, let the rivers flow, multiple streams, multiple favor, multiple glory, multiple increase, multiple fire, multiple places, multiple levels, multiple dimensions, multiple strategies, multiple innovation, multiple strength, multiple glory, multiply, God, multiply, God, multiply, God, confirm, oh God, confirm, oh God, confirm, oh God, strengthen and settle, strengthen and keep it, in the name of Jesus. Talitha Kumai, arise right now, arise and take your place in God, arise and take your position in God, arise and take your position in the kingdom, arise and go, arise and pursue, arise and conquer, arise and do it, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, 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 Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Multiply. Thank you, God. 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 Multiply. Thank you, Jesus. Multiply. Thank you, God. Multiply, God. Yes, Shana Moshiyala Basita. In the name of Jesus, 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 no depression will come over you, for God is multiplying you. No depression, no depression will come over your life, because God is multiplying you. No evil shall befall you, because God is multiplying you. There is no room for the enemy. There is no room for the enemy. There is no place where he can creep in. There is no place where he can enter in. There is no room for the enemy. Because God has sealed you up. There is no room for it. There is no room for it. There is no room for failure. There is no room for sickness. There is no room for it. Because there is no room. There's no room. There's no room. There's no room. There's no vacancy for it. There's no room for it. There's no room for it. Thank you, God. There's no room for it. There's no room for you to feel sorry for yourself. There's no room. Come on, somebody. There's no room for sickness. I'm too full of his glory. There's no room for depression. I'm too full of his glory. Even if you lost, there's some people who've been mourning. Even if you've been mourning, there's no room for it. There's no room for it. You're mourning because you're human, but there's no room to quit. There's no room to quit. It's too much faith in you. There's no room to stop. It's too much faith in you. There's no room to go down. It's too much faith in you. There's no room for tumors. It's too much faith in you. Come on, somebody. There's no room for wickedness. It's too much God in you. There's no room. There's no room for it because there's too much of God in you. In the name of Jesus, I got to go. I got a flight to catch. I got a flight to catch. I got to go. God, I thank you. God, I thank you. God, I thank you. God, I thank you. Connect with us. Connect with us. Go to our website. Connect with us. Sow on it. Go to our website. There's no room for generational curses. There's no room for it because there's too much of God in me, baby. There's no room. There's no room. There's no room for it. It's too much of heaven in me. Come on, somebody. Hell can't dwell in here. It's too much of heaven in me. Come on, somebody. All glory to God. Lord Jesus, I praise you, God. I praise you, God. I praise you, God. Go to our website. Connect with us. Sow a seed on this word. This is your word. Sow a seed on it. LaTriceRyan.com. The ways to sow are on the screen right now. The ways to sow on the screen. Go to our website. LaTriceRyan.com. There is no room for failure. Mm-mm. There is no room for failure. That's my story and I'm sticking to it. There is no room for failure. There is absolutely no way I can fail because there is no room for failure. There is no room for the enemy to creep in. We sealed up. Lord, I feel God up in here. There's no room for it. We're sealed up. There's no room for it. There's no room for it. LaTriceRyan.com. There's no room for witchcraft. There's no room for witchcraft to come in. It's too much of God in here. There's no room for the enemy to creep in. It's too much of God in here. There's no room for rebellion over our children. It's too much God in you. It's too much God over your babies. Too much word over them. There's no room for it. There's no room for it. In the name of Jesus. Yes, God. Yes, God. Download our app, LaTriceRyan.com. Download our app, LaTriceRyan. Search it on Google Play. Get my new workbook. Finish Your Guide to Getting It Done. There's no room. There's no room. Get my new book. Finish Your Guide to Getting It Done. There's no room. There's no room. I thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. LaTriceRyan.com. You can do it by Cash App, LaTrice Ryan. There's no room. There's no room. There's no room. There's no room. No vacancies for deficit. No vacancies. Yes, God, for debt. No vacancies for death. No vacancies for the enemy to come in. There's no room. There's no room. There's no room. Hallelujah. If you do not know the Lord Jesus and you want to know him, if you do not know the Lord Jesus and you want to know him, we do this every single Tuesday. We cannot pray. Glory to God. God give you the overflow. God bless you. Heal your body. And you don't know Jesus. Lord have mercy. Know your healer. Know your healer. Know the one that healed you. Thank you, Jesus. I want you to know your Jesus. I want you to know your Jesus. Come on, somebody. I want you to know your Jesus. I want you to know your Jesus. If you do not know Jesus and you want to know him, lift up your hands right now. Lift up your hands right now. Glory to God. You want to know Jesus. You're saying, I'm unsaved, but I got to know Jesus. I got to know Jesus. I'm unsaved, but I'm a soul winner. Souls, that's the main thing. That's what it means to me. Souls, that's my mandate. It's all about souls. It ain't about nothing else. It's all about souls. And if you want to know Jesus, you don't know Jesus, and you want to know him. God did not lead you on this prayer line randomly. It's not a coincidence. It's not a coincidence that you are on this prayer line, but you're saying, I want to know Jesus. Glory to God. Just lift up your hands. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I want to know Jesus. Lift up your hands and just begin to repent. Or if you knew him, but you're in a backslidden state, and you're saying, I got to come back to him. Lift up your hands. Hallelujah. Woo! Glory to God. Glory to God. Go and just begin to repent. I'm sorry, God. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, God. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Lord, I need to know you. I'm tired of living in darkness. I need to know you, Jesus. I need to know you, Jesus. I want to know you, Jesus. I want to know you. 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 Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Repeat after me, Lord Jesus. Ha! Thank you, Jesus. I'm sorry for my sins. Come into my heart. Save me, Lord. Deliver me, Lord. Renew me, Lord. I believe that you died for my sins. I believe that you rose for my sins. I confess with my mouth. Believe in my heart, and I accept you over my life as Lord over all. Save me, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Deliver me, Lord. And with your help, I know I can make it. I live for you, Jesus, all the days of my life. In Jesus' name, it is so. Amen. Amen. If you do not have a church home or connected to a ministry, please inbox me and I will lead you. I will make a recommendation in your area so that you can connect with a Bible-believing ministry. Thank you for connecting with us. We are the church. Thank you for connecting with us. Many of you, this is your church, the Awakening Prayer Call, the Awakening Prayer Line. This is your church. This is your ministry experience. I thank God that God has connected us in this hour. I do not take it for granted, and I do not take advantage of it. I don't take it lightly. But I thank God for our connection, that we are connected. I thank God that he has commissioned my husband and I to cover you in this season. I thank God for that, and I do not take it lightly. Connect with us. You are not by yourself, and you don't have to be by yourself. Connect with us, LaTriceRyan.com. So, glory to God, LaTriceRyan.com. On Cash App, LaTrice Ryan. I love you. I thank God for you. I praise God for you. We are, remember, there is no room for the enemy. Prophesy over your life. Speak to it in Jesus' name. God bless you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It is so. May the Lord God bless you and keep you. May he cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May he lift up his countenance. May all men call you blessed. We bless you in the name of Jesus, and we seal this prayer with shalom. May there be nothing missing, broken, or lacking in your life. Shalom.